Welcome back to another episode of Dads at Dark. It's Dakota, Casey, and Alex here for another episode.
I have to pee.
You always gotta piss, bro. You broke the seal, didn't you?
I did, but I don't actually have to go right now.
This has literally been a thing since...
Oh, dude, it's me and my squirrel bladder, bro. It's me and my squirrel bladder. I mean, I can't change it.
His seal is the diameter of a 5-gallon bucket, which is just non-fucking dude, existent.
It's like a 5-10 O-ring, really.
That's not a good night. Like, tell me I'm wrong. So, earlier this week, me and the baby watched one of my favorite cult classic movies. And by that, I mean I watched it and he slept.
Drooled a little bit.
He's not really a drooler, man.
That is true. I've not really seen him dribble a whole lot anytime I've been around.
No, dude, he's literally been the calmest, coolest. Like, he's the best baby. You don't fuss too much. And he's honestly, like, it's been a really, really big relief. Because the oldest was all about me. The middle one was all about the wife, and he's just like, I don't care who, just give me attention.
That's all you can ask for.
So it works out. Like, him and I hang out on my days off while she's working. But yeah, like I said, so this past Monday I had off, and we watched Napoleon Dynamite.
Oh shit.
Correct me if I'm wrong, did they make a second one?
No, they made an animated series.
Okay, I thought I had seen something about...
I don't know that I've ever... I want to say I might have watched it. No, I did. Me and the wife watched an episode when it came out, and it was kind of terrible.
Oh, okay, so it's not worth it then.
I feel like just to
check it out and see if there's anything to make humor out of.
Honestly, yeah, now that I watched the movie again, I kind of want to give it another try.
Yeah, a little bit of a refresher, that makes sense. Because honestly, the animators and whatnot who did the story of it probably did the same thing, kind of refresh their mind and then went from there, kind of build off of it.
Yeah. I'm not really into dry humor, and that's all that movie is dry humor.
I'm the same way. Like, The Office is a good example, and I know that Mikey's gonna hate this, but I've tried so many times, I can't get behind it. I even looked up the funniest moments on YouTube, and out of like an 11-minute video, I laughed once. This is like, okay, this is just, it's not for me. But Napoleon Dynamite, I can watch that shit anytime, and I will laugh every time.
Oh, go ahead.
I'm sorry. The Office was one of those ones that I wasn't really big into. Like, I'd see, like, one episode, and I'm like, yeah, it's not really for me, which, you know, I guess I'm kind of picky on as far as what I watch. But that, I actually watched it the whole way through, and I've watched it multiple times now, all the seasons and everything. It does, there's things, like, you'll pick up, like, watching it, and actually it is pretty funny. I used to not think it was funny, like the humor just wasn't there for me, but then if you watch it a couple times, you're like, okay, that's pretty fucking funny.
Honestly, it's probably what it is. It's just like an acquired taste, and I don't have it yet.
But it's not just like what they say, it's more of like their actions, like, you know, whatever's said to whoever, just their facial expression of just, if it's like something they say and it's just pure disgust, that shit just cracks me up. Because it's one of those things, like, somebody says something, you're like, and it's like, you can almost read what they're thinking in their head, which is one of those, like, what the fuck is wrong with this guy?
So a lot like our fucking friend group then.
Yeah.
So I'm usually the guy who's in question.
That's literally entirely what makes me laugh about Napoleon Dynamite. He has the same facial expression the whole movie.
Just unenthusiastic, like, I hate it here, but I kind of love my life.
Right? But I mean, like, the stupid things, like when that bully kicks him in the pocket that he had the tots
His
in.
fucking thoughts, yeah.
Yeah.
You guys are gonna hate me. I've actually never watched Napoleon
Are you
Dynamite.
serious?
What's wrong with you?
I don't hate you, I'm just disappointed. Fuck.
Dude, I don't know. I've never. It's.
Did you not have Comedy Central? Because that shit was on like all the time.
I was
mean,
on. I was watching Spike TV, man. As soon as it hit 11 o'clock, Mansers was on. That's it.
You know, I never actually watched that channel at all.
Really? Okay.
Yeah,
so we
never.
Got. Okay. What the fuck? Why am I the middle of this shit?
See, I got burnt out on TV because my parental figures growing up, they wanted to watch all the stupid shows like on VH1. It was like
Roxanne.
Rock of Love and like Flavor of Love and that dumb shit.
Flavor Flav.
Don't get me wrong, I got respect for Flavor Flav and like Bret Michaels, but those shows were so staged and so fucking stupid.
Oh, dude, I mean, look
there
at
was
the
another
player.
One on VH1 too, where it was just like a bunch of it was like a bunch of celebrities in a household and they were like playing games.
Oh, yeah.
And I remember there was like a big Vanilla Ice freaked out on like
what
Ron Jeremy.
Like, probably because he was over there so fluffing himself.
No, like there was like some big betrayal where Ron like voted for him to get out of the house. And he like freaked out and started fucking shit up.
I can't.
Dude, I'm so
that
glad.
One.
I'm so glad shit like that is not like the mainstream on TV anymore.
I was like,
actually,
Thousand Ways to Die too.
Actually, you know, don't quote me on that because I haven't had actual cable in 5 years, so maybe I just don't see
it
anymore.
That's
I'm also
I'm
fine
saying.
With that.
I've not watched actual like cable TV in or even fucking satellite, I guess, aside from streaming services.
Yeah, that's all
that's
I watch.
All we have.
Pluto TV and Cops.
I don't watch enough TV to merit paying that, you know? Like, in no sense.
Speaking of.
If for kids and shit like that, any of their shows is going to be on a streaming service. You can just go and search it.
Oh, yeah. And see, between me and my in-laws, we have pretty much everything. Like, we have Max, we have Paramount Plus, Hulu, Netflix, Amazon.
You know what's fucked up though? You're listing all
there's
these
another
off.
One too, and I can't think of
all
what
of
it
the
is.
Subscriptions added together is
right.
About a cable bill, if not more.
Yeah, but that's also including I would include like my Spotify in there.
You also got to think
which
of this
also.
Too. You always had to pay extra for the fucking like extra channels and shit. Like, oh, what's that? You want to have this and that and fucking Star
right.
And HBO? You got to pay $60 more.
You're right, but I mean,
they got you covered. Just pick one.
I will say at least, like, my Spotify has been a payoff because, you know, I horse traded with a friend. I get YouTube Premium for free. He gets Spotify Premium for free. Because he has, like, a family plan, and so do I. Oh, it is.
I wouldn't mind
great.
Having YouTube Premium, but I'm not paying for that shit.
I wouldn't have ever paid for it on my own, but I will say, just having no ads.
It was water.
Ad blocker, but you can't have that on your phone. Well, you can, but
yeah.
It doesn't work very well. At least in my case.
Dude, no, I
give
can't
water.
Have that. I have an iPhone.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Simplicity.
No offense. You know, there are some things that I really like about the iPhone, like family features and shit like that. But as soon as I can upgrade, I'm going straight back to a Samsung. This phone has made me so angry.
So I take it you got the white one and not the black one, huh? Because you're coming back.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
Terrible.
No, hey, I gave it a shot. I mean, it made sense at the time, though. Because, you know, I went in there and that day, miraculously, the exact phone that I was looking at, you know, was like $20 would lower my bill $20, and it did. But I said fuck it and gave it a shot, and I didn't like it, so I'm going back to an Android, and that's that.
I mean, that wasn't gonna last long.
Yeah, right. Well, this isn't the first time either. You had that fucking I think it was like an iPhone 3 or 4.
No, it was no the 4S.
That was that what it was? The one you had in the orange case?
Yeah, that was the first like Siri phone.
Okay, yeah. I was gonna say I remember you had that thing and you said you absolutely hated it. You liked it at first and then started to hate it.
Yeah, that's pretty much how it went. I think it was just because of like some of the games that I could get on there.
But with Android, you can just go and download that shit third party, and all it's going to do is ask you, there's a risk of virus. Do you want to do this? And you just,
yes.
Yeah. That is one thing that I majorly miss about having an Android. Like, there's a game that I was playing on my phone because I could, you know, swap it between the computer and my phone. And it was a third party app that I downloaded from Discord. And never gave me any issues, but I can't even download it because there's a prompt that's like, no, you're not allowed to do that. Because we're Apple, and if it doesn't say Apple on it, then you're not allowed.
Yep. Fucking hiccups.
And like, dude, it's so weird. Like, if it's, like, even things like Bluetooth headphones I've noticed, if it's not Apple brand, you have issues every so often. Never with the actual Apple products. Because they want you to spend that extra money.
Oh, that's all it is. I mean, this shit literally gets made. I can't remember what the exact statistics were. The phones are not really worth that much being where they're made because of the abundance of materials. And then they get sold to us and imported for profit, essentially. And then we overpay like a motherfucker.
Dude, everything has gone through the roof.
That's
everything.
Part of the reason why I stopped giving a shit about having the newest tech. Like, I don't care. As long as it functions, I'm cool with it.
Go ahead.
I'm going to go ahead and say this now. I know where this is going to lead to. I'm already going to go ahead and drop it. But the 70,000 AT&T people that had no service.
I forgot about that.
That was a test.
Oh? Conspiracy theories?
All right.
Well,
yeah,
so I did my own digging, because obviously shit's getting real fucking hairy.
Oh, absolutely is.
So,
no doubt.
What it was is, there's all these fears lately about EMPs and shit like that. The thing is with the infrastructure and just shutting off phones, that it's controlled. Whereas an EMP, like, it wipes out fucking everything.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, unless it's 6 feet below the Earth's soil. Fun fact.
Yep. So DHS and everything else has already disclosed it was a cyber attack. But the thing is they were saying that at 4 a.m., there was an update or something for AT&T. That's when the phones went down or some shit. And then from there, what they were saying is there was probably some phishing software that was downloaded that would access all your information once everything came back online. So literally all the information, and now it's just a sitting cell for whenever they want to just turn off. They can turn it off.
I heard it's like a line of code.
Yep, exactly. Oh, I guess you probably saw the same video. The guy sitting there at the desk talking about it.
I think this dude was sitting in his car. But anyway, yeah, I heard him say something that's like a line of code that gets in your phone.
A line of coke?
Making that shit super fast, so it goes from your bank account to their, Target gift card, probably.
Yeah. Sorry for the inconvenience.
But anyway, yeah, and then what did he say after that? He's like, even if you call and, like, the IT service people help you, and they, like, you know, see that line of code in there and delete it, damage is already done.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, everything, all your information's already been stolen.
That's scary shit. You know, there's a lot of people that do, like, we all do it. We all shop on our phones. We all pay bills on our phones.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and no matter what, you know, it's, we can go through and delete shit all we want, like take card numbers and shit off of our accounts, but it's in the fucking internet. It's in the air. It's there forever. There is a yeah. stamp of it somewhere forever.
Yep. I mean, I've already done my contemplation about just falling off the grid, just going incognito, because, I mean, shit's just, I mean, yeah, it might be too late, but...
I'm telling you, let's all get together. Let's all get together. And we're all going to go buy a fucking chunk of land and get
West Virginia, son.
Solar and Starlink, and we'll start a homestead.
Starlink yeah, is garbage, I'm going to tell you now.
My dad's already on that process. He bought 5 acres or whatever over the mountain, and
my cheap. Father, he ordered it too. Said it was like $500.
I don't know how much it was. I just know that the satellite stake that the initial like dish was planted in, the right. pole was still there because they literally got a mount like the fucking I guess the mount for the thing. And they don't take that. They just take the device itself.
Oh.
Yeah, we had it for a month, and in 2 days, for what we had, what they allotted us for our data, ran uh-huh. out. And then it was decreased by, like, 80% or some shit. So, super, super slow internet speeds, and very, very laggy on anything you tried to do.
Oh, so they had you on, like, a data plan where you could only do, like, so many gigs.
Yeah.
It ran out fast
as hell.
See, that was the issue when we bought this house out here. It was, there was a place they offered, the highest speeds I could get when we moved out here, like, 5 years ago. It was, like, 150 megabytes through the local company. And they had you on a data plan like that, too. And I'm like... Dude, I'll burn through that in a night, you know, and that's not to say if it's not already burn up by the time I get to log on.
Right.
So I'm like, fuck that. So I dealt with 40 megabyte speeds from another company, but the local company got bought out, and they've been really fucking nice for the most part. I mean, we did have some troubles, but they did get their shit fixed, and so far it's been great. But we went from 200 megabyte speeds with them is what I signed up for initially, and then one day I just did a random speed test. They bumped us up to 400 megabyte with no upcharge or nothing. And I was like, sweet, then we upgraded our modem with them, and we got their gig speed, and, dude, I'm telling you, the gig speed has been great. Like, she can work upstairs on the Wi-Fi, and I can sit down here and play games, and neither one of us get bothered. Like, no lag or anything, it's been really fucking sweet. Now, I'm really hoping Xfinity gets out here soon, because they're gonna bring fiber, and you can't touch fiber. I'm sorry. That shit is fucking insanely fast.
Yes, it is. I mean, I don't know how it is. Never used it in a household, but I know for work they have that, and it's good, but for a large base like company, I think you might need more than one.
I can see that.
I mean, they have, I don't know how many damn cameras running at the same time. Like, they are literally all streaming. It's easily just shy of 200, I think.
Oh, I believe it. I mean, that's a big-ass building.
It is. Doesn't look like it from the outside. You get in there, and it's a maze.
Oh, I believe that.
Yeah. Anyways, enough internet talk.
Yeah, enough internet talk. But yeah, cult classic movies, man. There are so many of them, like, I can't believe... I'm still blown away that Alex has never seen Napoleon Dynamite.
Yeah, what honestly, the fuck? That, yep. What the fuck? Caught me off guard.
Yeah, I'm, bro. Go when we're done with this. I will personally log on to Hulu and stream it so you watch it.
Currently on my monitor, I'm watching the trailer for Kingmakers on Steam, and my boy's on my lap watching this monkey and this dog. What? It's Ben Bong Duck Monkey Baby Kittens Puppy Ghost Koi Cat and Swims Rabbits Animals Eats Egg I don't know. It's called Monkey Oxy on YouTube.
It sounds like somebody
buddy...
who just got to the country and learned English and they can't quite piece it together yet.
I don't know. It's this monkey that does, like, people things. Like, he has his own kitchen. He rides in the back of an RC dump truck.
So
right now, he's wearing,
Curious George?
But like
yes,
IRL?
But it's a little monkey. Yes.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
It's a real monkey. Yeah, my boy likes this. I mean, we've been on a monster truck kick, and now we're, been watching this monkey.
Turns 8 years old and rips their face off.
I do have a
I don't know what
kind of
monkey is here.
It's not something to watch with kids.
It's a recommendation.
Oh boy.
It's probably not.
No. It never is. It's either violent or vulgar.
Sometimes both.
Yeah, this one's just violent. But it's a new fucking anime that came out from Adult Swim. It's called Ninja Kamui.
What does it say again?
The show is called Ninja Kamui.
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 Say it with me. Kamui.
Kamui.
Kamui. I feel like we're summoning a fucking...
a Ninja Kamui.
I heard the doorbell ring and there's ramen at my front door.
But, yeah, basically it's about, from what I'm gathering, it's about an ex, like, special forces ninja.
Okay, I'm in.
And he, like, runs off with his family, and the old agency finds him, and they murk his family, and thought they murked him, but then he comes back to life, and he just starts fucking tearing people apart. And I mean, this motherfucker is cold.
So I'm actually looking up this thing right now. There's a comic that Keanu Reeves co-wrote.
No shit.
And apparently they're making an animated series. It's called Berserker. It's spelled B-R-Z-R-K-R.
I've heard something about this.
Dude, apparently they're... I saw something the other day where they're gonna make like an animated series of it. I mean, it looks like I've seen some like screenshots of pages. It looks badass.
Nothing wrong with that. Dude, Keanu Reeves, I don't think I've seen anything bad from him.
Well, the artist of the comics actually
kind of bother me, but like I don't know. I get
time for bed.
Have you guys ever seen the one where he, like, plays an artist and, like, the two underage girls frame him?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's got Ana de Armas in it.
Yeah, dude, the one scene does make me laugh. He, like, calls them whores or something, and the, like, Russian girl's like, "We're not fucking whores, you're the fucking whore." Fucking gets
That's
me.
Just, like...
But it's such a serious
There's always that
movie,
one line.
Laugh.
There's always that one line in a movie, like, every time I think of Sausage Party, it's just, thick you, weenie. Like, it's just...
You were classic for that for a while.
Oh, dude.
We all were.
Yep.
How many
yep.
fucking times did we just get plastered and watch that movie?
I was usually the end game of the night.
It always was, but I mean, like, that was a... That was a
cooking up the
rich...
ketos and ramen with a butterball
well,
out there
that.
With a fork in it, pissing off your wife.
Oh my god,
too cheesy,
dude.
Did you fucking fork my butter?
Well, no, it was the YouTube. We'd watch Fail Army, like Fails of the
yeah.
Week. I
World
remember
Star.
Casey and I for
yeah,
like an
that.
Hour.
We
watched,
Star, and then there was another just straight meme channel that we watched every fucking week religiously. That shit was like church.
There's this. It was like every Friday night or Saturday night for at least an hour, we'd watch this video of this cat eating ice cream and have a brain freeze and die laughing.
You know, we've brought it up on this fucking podcast before. What in the fuck did you sit on my shitter and
I was thinking the same
lose
thing.
Your
Something
mind about
a dog,
about that
wasn't
night
it?
You got all fucked up.
So I was actually trying to recollect these memories the other day because I actually kind of had an experience like that a couple weeks ago. Well, not it wasn't
Fill us in.
it wasn't. So I ended up receiving something. Can't go into details of it. But I did. But it was like an hour later. I was like nothing. I was like okay. I was like this is retarded. Then it was about a half hour later, I felt funny. I was like, dude, I'm not okay. Like I wasn't sick, but I just didn't feel right. All of a sudden, then like my knees were swollen. I'm like, okay. And then I had trouble walking. So I had to like I was like scooting around. And then finally I got in the chair and then wanted to play I was playing a game or something with the old hunter. And he was like talking, and I just wanted to respond it. And he kept saying, "Are you okay?" And I'm like, "Yeah, I'm okay." And then I was like, "No, I'm not okay. I gotta get off." So I went back to bed, and dude, I felt like I was melting. I was like, "This is not good. Like, I just don't feel good." My old lady, she was in the clouds. She was feeling good. I did not feel good. It wasn't like a not like it wasn't like being sick. I was uncomfortable. And then I woke up and I felt like shit. I'm like, yeah, never again.
Understood.
But yeah, after all that though, but no, I was recollecting on all my past ventures with
Bro.
just comical stuff. I don't recall that night.
The night of the night we
There's a
sat in
lot.
the fucking cobalt and we fogged it out with our fucking vapes and we couldn't breathe and like almost suffocated ourselves.
Prep me for the gas chamber in Fort Benning. So,
Bro, that shit was ridiculous. We couldn't even see each other.
yeah, I remember sitting there like, now thinking back on it, oh yeah, that's horrible.
But
Like,
take
we.
that shit up a notch. Me and Cooter here did that to his trailer. You couldn't see his,
Oh.
you couldn't see the TV from the front porch.
Well, hell, even the
I would have laughed if
doorway,
you would
you
have had a
walk
window cracked
inside, you couldn't
open.
see nothing.
I
It was
know, dude.
just white.
I was, we're really fortunate that I was making vape juice at that point in time. Because
We
otherwise.
used a good bit.
Yeah, because that would have been pretty expensive otherwise.
Probably why my teeth are fucked up.
Dude, no, well, it wouldn't have been for my juice because I didn't use the artificial flavoring like
Oh
some of these
no.
fucking companies do.
I only got from you a few times too. It was definitely those. And I mean I wasn't doing it right either. So now I got slight cracked teeth.
I made craft vape juice.
The lemonade was
It was
my personal favorite.
artesian.
My lemonade. Honestly, my favorite flavors because there was a tie between three of them.
Blue raspberry custard?
N honestly, that was my best selling, but it wasn't one of my favorites. It was probably like my third favorite. Because it was good. I mean, I actually put a lot of time and effort into that specific flavor.
I miss the Amish ones. Those were so good. They were delicious.
Yes, the
Angry
one that,
Amish.
yeah, the one that tasted like the damn fucking Texas Roadhouse butter.
Yes. Oh, fuck me up. Dude, those shits were good.
They really were. There was a lot of fucking art. There was a lot of sweetener in those, though. That's why they were
Yep.
so damn good.
Yep.
Dude, I, like I said, I literally never used one bit of any sort of sweetener in mine.
Wow, they were good. I don't think they needed it, to be honest.
Well, dude, I mean, just that blueberry custard flavor I had. Dude, it's kind of weird that I can still remember how to make that right off the top of my head, like how many drops. I had it down to the drops. I could just count drops.
Down to
But
the science.
there was probably nine different flavors in that. And there's some weird ones too. Like there was marshmallow, graham cracker, like two different kinds of blueberries. mostly vanilla, but yeah. No, my favorite out of my lines were the cereal milk, the Fruit Loops.
Can we go to bed?
And honestly, I didn't have it for very long, but I did have a waffle with maple syrup flavor that was fucking awesome. I only got sample bottles of it, and I made all of it for myself.
That, yeah, honestly, that sounds fun.
I remember the first time.
Oh, now.
Well.
Right. No, you go ahead and say what you're going to say.
I was just going to say about how I remember, like, one of the first times the wife ever stayed over at the party pad.
Ah, when you guys were first dating, yeah.
Yeah. And she opened the fucking dishwasher, and it was literally top and bottom filled with all the bottles that Rob used to give me.
Literally, that kitchen was used for so many purposes. It was a vape shop. It was a fucking mechanic shop.
Yeah, I didn't,
it was a party pad.
No, I didn't mix the juice in the kitchen.
Oh, it was close to the kitchen. You had that little hideaway in the hallway.
Yeah, that's where it was. And I mean, I kept that really sanitary. Like,
oh yeah, no. I mean, that's
but
not
you are correct. You are correct.
That kitchen got a lot of use.
Dude,
I wonder if there's dents in the wall.
It was.
Oh
my
Jesus,
god!
It was Alex with his turntables.
Yep.
I actually pulled them some bitches out like a couple weekends ago.
Oh,
well, I mean, you guys remember?
Back into it.
Actually, I thought about it.
Most of these things that I'm about to say are like things first time. You know, the wife would walk into the apartment and see and be like, are you fucking kidding me? And then after a while, she just kind of got used to it. But like,
that was a circus.
Dude, the fucking time I had the R6 in the kitchen.
Oh boy.
I remember I was in the living room and she walks in. I hear the dogs and I like kind of sit up and I hear her go, what in the fuck? Are you fucking serious? And she just kind of pokes in, gives me that, like, you know, look of why. And my only response was a smart ass, well, you know, it's cold outside, and if I'm cold, then she's cold, so I gotta bring it in. Dude, I literally went and got 2 pieces of carpet to put the jack stands, because it was up on the jacks. Well, the stand, not jacks, but the stands. So, I mean, I at least made sure it wasn't going to do any damage. And it didn't leak. But I did.
It did its job. It did its job.
But I did, after using my buddy's garage, rest in peace, Kib. But after using his garage to paint an entire set of tins and bags and fairings for, I can't remember what the year was, but it was a Harley Road King. Then that kitchen was used to wet sand and buff and polish all those pieces. And I'm telling you, you guys remember, that shit looked like glass.
You're welcome for the sanding.
Oh yeah, you did help me wet sand. I taught you how to wet sand that day.
I mean, I already knew how to sand, but it was just a little bit different. Let's just put a little bit of water on there. Get to it.
Yeah, but you have to be, like, really careful. Because that is, like...
You know, for my first time, if it still turned out glassy, I think I'll do a damn good job.
No, I mean, yes and no. I mean, that was half you, that was also half me, because... I can,
hey,
let me make a hole. A whole ass.
A whole ass.
But yeah. But no, because I will tell you, I have seen some people do some, like, perfect sanding.
And then people do some really...
Oh my, I've seen people... I'll tell you, one of the things that I did in my rookie years that pissed me off the most, it was the cobalt. It was right after I painted it. I
at least this was your own piece, though, not somebody who was like inquiring about work. So
yeah, but whenever I needed that car to get back and forth to work, I was on a deadline. Basically, what happened, and it was a string of events too. I was buffing out the front bumper, and right around the passenger's headlight, I had the headlights out, obviously. But I got a little too close to the edge with the old wool pad and snagged it. And that nice, fresh, like, two-day-old paint, I burned right through that thing. And I mean, a big chunk. So then I was pissed off about it, and I didn't do everything correctly, and I cut some corners and realized real quickly why you don't do that shit. Because after I had sprayed color on it and I was getting ready to mix clear, the paint wrinkled on me. So then I had to let it set till the next day, and so that put me a day behind. And the color I picked was a real fucking bitch to blend. But it was a fucking... that carbon black with the green pearl in it. So fucking nice.
I was gonna say, that was a pretty fucking nice looking car.
I miss that fucking car. I had a lot of good memories in that car.
The main one that sticks out to me is going down to the beach. I think it always will.
Motherfucker, dude, I slapped you in the chest. Dude, there's a cop, roll your fucking window down.
Because of the fucking tits. We were out of state, though. Would they have been able to do anything about that?
Oh, yeah.
Because I know in our state, say you go south of the border and get your shit registered there and get your license plate and all that from that state, then you can have tint done to it, and the our police can't do anything about it.
I mean... I don't really want to get into the technicalities of how that should never be a citation.
I mean,
anyway.
I'm just talking out of my ass, to be honest. I have no idea. Just what I was told, like, fuck, dude, it's been 10 years, so it could have changed.
Unfortunately, in my younger years, my stubbornness has led me to be an expert in this specific field.
How many times was it you got hit in town? I know one time was with me.
Eight.
Eight! Jeez, I was gonna say four, and you doubled it.
I got two the first year, and then I got one every year after that I owned that car. Same cop.
Yeah, no, he just recognized, I mean,
we're on a first name basis.
Wasn't hard to identify your vehicle. I mean, it was pretty custom for the area.
I will at least say, though, I have the winning streak because I took pretty much all of them to court. 5 out of 8 isn't bad.
No, I would say so.
So but the other three of them? Yeah, now, the second one that I actually had to pay on, though, they were all only $128. They're $128.50 total. At least they were the last time I got one. And I was always a little smartass, and I was like, yeah, I'll do payment plans. Fuck you. But I forgot to pay it the 1 week. I think it was bi-weekly I had to pay it, because you could set it up like that with your payment, like your pay schedule. And I remember I come home when I was still living at home, and my mom was like, do you want to fucking explain this? It was a warrant because I forgot to pay it. And I just looked at it, I was like, I didn't even know you could get a fucking... Is this how you get a warrant? Like, holy fuck. So I just hopped on the fucking computer real quick and paid it off. And then first thing in the morning, I woke up, called that courthouse, and I was like, hey, I paid this online last night. Is somebody gonna come fucking arrest me? I was like 19 then. I didn't know what the fuck was gonna happen, you know what I mean?
What do handcuffs feel like?
Dude, that's one thing. I have never been arrested.
honestly, knowing you, that is shocking.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, between all the fucking stupid shit that I, you know,
speaking
was involved
of
in,
some of the stupid shit we did during winter times, particularly a tree. Did you notice it's not there anymore? They took it down. Really? They cut that bitch down.
Did they really?
Yeah.
I think that's some bullshit.
Went past about 2 weeks ago with my lady, and I was looking over there, and I was like, holy shit, the fucking tree's not there anymore. And sure enough, yeah, they're remodeling the place, something. I don't know what the hell they're making it. I don't believe it's going to be what it used to be. If it is, it's just going to be revamped.
I think it's supposed to be like a church thing.
I mean, it would make sense.
But didn't, I thought they replanted it. Like a new tree.
I'm not sure. I didn't see a cage out there or anything for like a sapling.
Hmm. Maybe I'm wrong. I still have that ornament.
Oh yeah, that night.
Yeah, that night. You know exactly what we're talking about.
Yeah,
you?
What's up? Mm-hmm. What's up, fellow bush attacker?
Oh my.
I don't know what the hell. And dude, then we had some kind of fucking vendetta against plants that night.
You guys did.
One,
I was just feeling
one
gay
individual
gabbing,
had
apparently.
one individual had an issue with the tire of a Camry.
Yeah, no, that was a van.
Yep.
That was a
what
van. Dude, he really did. He had no shame. He just whipped that shit out and just started pissing.
Do you remember?
Coming.
Oh, you weren't out there that night, were you? I want to say, I believe we're still calling him Gingy.
Yes.
Went out and just pissed.
I think he got name dropped earlier.
Was that the Spermer night?
No, this was at his Maryland house.
Dude.
Hate that.
That old man that used to live across the street from him. Swear
dude,
to
he
God.
He was the dude. Most wholesome dude you could have had as a neighbor.
He was fucking awesome. I like that guy a lot. Like, every time he came over to shoot the shit, he was just cool. He had a lot of fucking really, like, almost useless information, but not really.
It's useless at the time, but could be useful
yes.
later.
Yeah. Something you just kind of think about later, like, oh,
I'm good for that, too, work. So I can relate.
Yeah, same.
6 feet under the earth. Just telling you. You don't want that shit to get fucked up, and you got electronics. Well,
I'm gonna bring something up off of this, too. But, like, just a little thing that I do, and I've actually kind of corrupted the wife into doing it too. Since working in the body shop and working with paint pretty much my entire adult life and some of my teenage years, I can look at a vehicle and tell you where it's been worked on. I can see it. And the wife can pick up on it now too, because it started out, I would just look at a brand new car, because most brand new cars do not get painted all in one facility. Well, maybe not the same facility, but, like, not on the same line. So there's different batches of paint. And to most people, you know, they're just going to be like, oh, yeah, that's a really nice color, da-da-da-da. Or I'm going to be like, yeah, the quarter panel doesn't match the doors.
Yeah, no, I can understand that. Because
now,
of different mixtures in the paint.
Well, it's, I mean, technically, you know, the same mixture, but it's not the same batch. You know what
no,
I mean?
Yeah, it, like, well, I mean, doesn't
it's
temperature also affect
same...
that at all? Say, like, they're cooking it in an oven that's fucking certain a temperature, and then the others is cooking in a temperature that's, like, a little bit lower. Does it come out a different color?
Well, you see, now that varies. Because a lot of your paints today aren't solvent-based, which it's weird, like, because I know from working in my paint shop now that I work at, it's, like, kind of ass backwards, because we would bake water-based paint at, you know, where I work now, and we wouldn't with the solvent base. Well, in the real world, you bake, it's the opposite. You do not bake water, like in, you know, just the automotive world. All you do with water is basically, it air dries. Now, the system that I used was PPG Envirobase, and you had a really fancy, big-ass air gun with a filter in it. And you just kind of blew air on it until it looked, you know, dry to the touch. Then once, you know, it was flashed off, then you could go out, clean your gun, get ready for clear coat. Which, oddly enough, in the shop that I worked at was solvent-based, over water, which caused some issues. I was the one to discover issues. I painted a whole rocker panel on this little Mazda truck, and when I went to start putting it back together, I just kind of like, I saw a piece of dirt or something, and I was like, went to rub it off, and it was a portion that I had painted, and it was kind of like, you remember that silly putty fart shit that we used to get whenever we were kids?
Flarp?
Flarp, yeah.
Yep.
You know how, like, that shit would kind of get, like, if you would leave it set out, it would kind of start to, like, get hard?
Yeah.
Where it was, like, you could just barely, like, form it?
Yep.
That's what this paint would do if you didn't cure it right. But anyway, I got so far off track. But what I was saying, since the wife has started picking up on like the differences in paints and shit like that, I was just talking to one of the older guys that I work with now, and he says, and a few other people agreed with him too, but apparently women can see shit like that better than men.
You got no knowledge on that.
Yeah, apparently, I forget what exactly. There's a part of the woman's eye that is just, like, a lot sharper to that shit than we are. And honestly, it makes sense because I have literally seen, you know, women painters see shit that I couldn't see until I really got up on it. And then I was like, oh, fuck. And, you know, they're standing, like, 5-10 feet back. And I'm like, how the fuck?
Dude, that was me with, like, the fucking bright-ass lights and trying to find touch-up spots. I could not put the beam directly on it. I had to put it to the side or I couldn't see it.
You were helping touch up white spots on a tan vehicle, and yeah, that's just the same.
They were fucking very similar, yeah.
Now, let me tell you, since everything's been green, you'd love it.
Oh, so yeah, easy. That'd be so fucking much easier.
Shit stands out like a fucking sore thumb.
Although, and I hate that it was happening before all of this bullshit, not trying to get all political, because I'm not a political person.
Yeah, we ain't political up in this bitch.
I hate that they were changing assets to green before I got let go, but that's besides the point. For the simple fact of current events, and being that the environment of current events are green and not tan anymore. Green or white, depending on where you're at.
The tank I just painted there for the fucking the Heritage Center.
Yeah.
The color they gave me for that tank, it was called Green Olive Drab. And let me tell you, that shit's fucking brown. Like, I mean fucking brown.
I have to fucking see the thing in person.
And one of the only things I've ever fucking painted that gave me, like, real bad claustrophobia.
Oh, yeah, dude, they are very tight. I remember back when I wanted to join the military, I wanted to initially be with Armored Division and be in a tank. You gotta be under a certain height because it's too cramped.
Well, dude, so, who was under there with me? We started, like, we split the bottom of it in half. it was me and fucking Sergeant Whiskers.
Sergeant Whiskers.
Yeah, you know who the fuck I'm talking about. Grumpy Gilmore. Hey, no, we'll just say that's Gilmore. But me and fucking Gilmore are under there painting it. And, you know, he's a smaller guy than I am. So he fit under there pretty okay. Like, he could wiggle around. Like, dude, I had to basically fucking swing my arm like I was doing a jumping jack. You know what I mean? Because I couldn't just fucking bend it like that. Like, I had no room. And my head was sideways, and I basically just cranked my fucking pressure up on everything so I could basically do some long distance painting. Like, I was probably painting perfect fucking lines about 4 feet behind me.
Damn.
Dude, well, and then I had to basically just, like, you know, I had an inch of wiggle space on each side to wiggle myself out. I was, like, so fucking relieved to get out from underneath that bitch. Now, it actually would, I would have had more room if the tracks were still on it. But the tracks were not on because they were going to be repaired.
How was that thing being moved? Did they use the inline tracks that they had set up initially?
Oh, hell no. I wish they would have. They basically brought it to the back of the building, put it in one of the back booths, and pushed it in with a track, with a tractor. But what they did it kind of slick. They unhooked the fucking track, just the length that they needed to unhook on each side, and then they pushed it backwards so it just rolled off the track so they could take it with them and go repair them. And then basically reverse the process to put the tracks back on.
It's interesting. Well, I mean, if the tracks need repaired, I guess it does make sense that they didn't use the system that was... So they also... They lost the tank contract, didn't they? Like, way back?
I couldn't tell you. Couldn't tell you.
I believe the old man was talking about that before he's passing. So I was asking him about, like, when I first started, I was asking him about what these tracks were for, but he had the fucking covers over them and all of that, and he said that he used to have a tank contract. I asked what happened to it, and I don't know exactly the details of it. Like, it was a pretty vague statement, but something along the lines of they lost it to another depot in the area or some shit.
I believe that, honestly. Probably, like, I can't fucking say it, but yeah.
Yeah, it is what it is.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's cool. I took the boys up last summer to see it while it was on. But anyway, buddy, so back to these cult classic films. You know, I think those are some of the best movies, honestly. Like, a lot of my top movies are cult classics.
To be honest, yeah.
And low budget shit, you know what I mean? Like, fucking the original Clerks.
Definitely. Definitely. Yeah, I mean, I don't know that Cheech and Chong movies were necessarily cult classics. I guess in a sense they could be.
Honestly, yes. I would consider them cult classics. Because, I mean, yeah, it's like everybody knows who they are, but I guarantee you the majority of people, you sit down and ask them if they've ever actually watched one of the movies. They'll be like, wait, there were movies?
You're right.
You know, I'm not going to sit here and say I've seen all of them. I've seen a few of them.
I don't know that I've seen all of them, but yeah, I have seen a few. I've seen Up in Smoke for sure.
Up in Smoke's one of my favorites. Nice Dreams is also one of my... I like that one a lot, too. That's got Pee Wee Herman in it.
Yes, I did see that one.
Yep, that one. It's so stupid. My mama talking to me, trying to tell me how to live. <Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da>.
Fucking love
So
those movies.
dumb.
They
But
are.
like,
It's just stupid humor, but it's the humor that gets you right in the feels.
well, I
The
mean, I've
feel good, I guess.
it's always been, I don't know, just like the low quality, low budget shit's what's always gotten me. Like my favorite TV series, Trailer Park Boys. Dude, that, like, I mean, that was supposed to be a mockumentary. And the first few seasons, man, they pulled that shit right off.
Went from a mockumentary to a fucking comedy.
Dude, I'm really happy that that shit, like, dude, they have their own thing now called SwearNet, you know, and they do all kinds of stuff. They have a podcast. They do like little web series. I honestly really want to subscribe because it's like $3 a month. And I think that's actually maybe where all the new episodes are going to, because I know they're not going to Netflix anymore, because I can't remember if the animated series season was the last one, or if they did another season after that. But I know one of those two things happened, and then they, like I said, they went off and started their own thing, and it's been great. That show, I mean, like I said, I've seen at least all the movies and all the shit on Netflix. I've watched it at least fucking 30 times.
Yeah, that was one of the end game nights too. It'd be Sausage Party or fucking Trailer Park Boys.
Dude, that's my kind of humor. The fucking weed and dick and fart jokes, man. They get me.
You can't go wrong there. I mean, I guess you can if you're uptight and snobby, but to each their own. I'm not gonna
Yeah.
judge you. Do you, boo boo? If you want to be miserable, that's cool by me.
That's right. That's right. I like to laugh.
You damn right. I can't imagine a world without laughter.
And like early Kevin Smith films too, like in general, not just Clerks. I should have said, like, you know, like Mallrats, fucking.
I believe some of these have already been referenced before too. Now that I'm thinking about it, because I'm pretty certain I referenced Dogma once.
Oh yeah, dude, Dogma, great film. Shit was so fun, like.
Yeah, I miss the old days when Comedy Central would just play those movies on weekends. Get off school, just have a nice chill weekend watching funny movies, and just it was a good time.
Dude, I watched so many movies because of Comedy Central. That's how I found like Son-in-Law and fucking Half-Baked.
I still feel like what got me introduced into really thoroughly enjoying stand-up comedy would have been the Comedy Central Friday night stand-ups.
You know, I started watching stand-up comedy because of like my parental figures at the time. You know, they were what big into Jeff Dunham whenever he was big. And, you know, his first few specials I thought were pretty funny, but I don't know. Personally, nothing against the guy. I think he's great at what he does, but it's kind of repetitive to me.
Yeah, no, I completely understand that. There's a few comedians I listen to that I feel the same exact way about, where you
But
listen
I
to a
would.
few different sets where it's literally in different areas. But I mean, at the same time, you got to realize they go off of a script that they make themselves, that they know how to play into it and feed the crowd.
Well, you are correct. Now, I mean, I will also say too. Well, I guess I shouldn't say it like that. But stemming from the Jeff Dunham stuff, though, I started looking into just like stand-up comedians in general, and I found like, you know, like Eddie Murphy Delirious. Dude, I'm telling you, the Eddie Murphy we grew up with and the Eddie Murphy that was back then, holy fuck, was he a raunchy son of a bitch. Oh, hilarious too. But then I moved, you know, then I found like not Jeff Dunham again. Damn it, the fucking Australian guy.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about.
You bunch of cunts.
Yep. Jesus, man. Why's it gotta be so late at night and I got smooth?
I know. Dude, this should be an easy one because his early shit was the fucking best. Damn it. Hold on.
I'm gonna cheat.
Yeah, I was gonna say, Google save me.
If I can.
Jim Jefferies.
Yeah, literally just looked at the little Jim Jefferies.
But I also have to give, you know, a shout out
Jeff
to
Jimmeries.
Jeff Jimmeries. That's a, you know, that's a really, I don't even know if that's dyslexic.
No, it's not. It's just fucking weird, smooth brain. That's all it is. Autism, baby.
You know, we do need to give some, like, fucking major shout-outs to the OGs, though.
Oh, yeah.
Or stand-up, like, Sam Kinison. Fucking, you know, Andrew Dice Clay. Rodney Dangerfield.
Dude, there's been a lot.
And one of my personal favorites, George Carlin.
You can't go wrong with George Carlin.
Dude, that was a funny mother
to this day.
Dude, and he didn't give a fuck what he made jokes about.
He was so fucking intellect about his shit, too. Like, he knew what he was talking.
And then he could do shit like his fucking cameo that he made in Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back, where he fucking sucked a trucker's dick. You know what I mean? That dude was just a fucking riot. We don't have fucking comedians like that anymore.
We do. We just have PC culture, but then you have the few who just don't give a fuck and do it anyway.
I'm
a fan. I support them.
Well, I miss comedy like that. Like,
it's,
you know, we all grew up
comedy.
With it. We all grew up laughing at it.
It has to be dark. I mean, it doesn't have to always be dark, but I mean, like, for the most part, like, if you can't joke about bad times, you're just a miserable person. I'm sorry to say.
Yeah.
That's the only way to get through it. If you can't laugh through the pain, you're going to get fucked.
I don't get it because, like, I just feel like growing up, you know, as, I guess, a quote-unquote millennial, you know, early 90s kid, that...
Yeah, we're, like, right on the, like, border.
Well, I'm just saying, like, dude, we grew up where we were taught, you know, that shit doesn't matter in a person. Like, you know, I at least interpreted it as you judge people off their character, and that's my personal way of dealing with fucking people.
And as we were talking
but
about
at the same time, you know, we all grew up with, like, I mean, every fucking adult cartoon from the start was raunchy. Family Guy used to be fucking horrible.
They still kind of are.
South Park.
What's the newer ones?
King of the Hill. Fucking, you know, the list goes on. Futurama.
Mm-hmm.
And then not to mention, like, the shit they had on Adult Swim. The Boondocks.
Dude, Boondocks. Yeah.
Aqua Teen. Robot Chicken.
Dude, I was watching a clip from the Boondocks 2 days ago. Yeah, it was 2 days ago. And I had a trainee. And I was just kind of scrolling through reels, and a Boondocks clip come on. And I watched it through, and I was like, oh. Honestly,
how did that survive?
I'm surprised they didn't say the N-word at least once. That's just, damn, bro.
Dude, that show was so bad for that.
And the funny thing is, the voice actor is a white dude.
I know. Fucking old Uncle Ruckus.
It's a good show, though.
It is. But, bro, so, what are your... We'll go with top three. Top three cult classic films.
Top three cult classics. Honestly, I don't even know that they would qualify for it. I just feel that they were low budget.
Hey, that, you know, it pretty much fits the criteria at that point, honestly.
Top three? In no specific order, I guess.
I mean, we can go back and forth if you need time to think.
Well, I was going to say...
we'll start from number three and work our way to the best.
I can't even fucking think of the name of the one. What the hell was one where they bought a college? Accepted.
Ask me about my wiener.
Yeah, accepted. Yeah, that by far, that makes one of them.
Okay. Right, where are you placing it so I know where to start?
I don't have a place for that yet. I'll just get a list and then I'll place them from there.
You know, okay, I can live with that. I can live with that. Fuck. I'm just gonna throw one out there. I don't know which one to throw out there first, though.
Are we doing copies or no copies? Because you might say something that changed my mind.
No. I mean, I feel like we should. Feel like we should do no copies.
That's what I was thinking.
Make it a little more versatile.
Give the notable mentions, honorable mentions. Yeah.
Yeah, we'll give some honorable mentions at the end. I said it earlier. I'm gonna put Napoleon Dynamite. I'm taking it.
That's fair. That's fair. You've watched that movie by far more than I have.
Fucking right, I have.
I don't know. I really don't think that fucking was. Was Boondock Saints a low budget movie?
You know, I would say the original is. You could throw that on there.
I mean, I literally got a tattoo for it. That's probably number one in my spot if it is. Kind of sad.
It is kind of sad.
Much better movies out there. I got a soft spot in my heart for the Boondock Saints. I love that movie.
You know, dude, that's one of my
favorites. They killed a Russian mobster with a toilet. Like, what the fuck?
They did. Yeah, I mean, you know, that movie was not supposed to do well at all. And like I said, it's one of my fucking top 10 films of all time. I love that movie.
Oh, sorry, I missed. What was the movie? Oh, yeah.
You just said it, bro.
Oh, yeah. I had to take my headset off for a second because I thought the dog was getting into something.
Fair enough.
But yeah, no. I guess it is.
It's your turn. No, wait, you said Boondock Saints for your second one.
Yeah, that's, I mean, I already know that's going to be number one. So I'll have to just pick two and three from there.
You know, I am, I'm going to take it back real old with my second pick and say Porky's.
Porky's. I honestly don't know that I've seen that one.
Dude.
I'm drawing a blank. I might have.
It's
like
it's
one of that ones that was in my face. I can like
I think
remember.
It was I think it was like out of the 70s. I think that's actually when it was made. It's a series of movies. It's about a group of high school kids that just get into all kinds of really fucked up situations. Like, there's one where they're, like, fucking peeping through this, like, wall to peep on girls in the locker room, and the ugly gym teacher grabs the one kid's pecker. Dude, it's...
Why does that sound like 70s comedy?
Dude, it's outrageous as fuck. Like, it's terrible. I should not have been watching that shit whenever I was.
You could tell it's a 70s porno.
Yes.
Dick has sideburns.
Yep. So that's what you call that shit. Like a fucking bird's nest. Little motherfucker, you know those birds that's like when they're like fucking standing up with their mouth open for food? Every white guy in the 70s.
<It's funny. laughs> Harry with a fucking open urethra?
Yes.
That sounds like a medical condition.
All right, so... Well, I guess, I guess so I should pick a fucking movie, yeah. Shouldn't I?
Yeah.
God damn. What am I doing here?
To Shrek! Low budget. No, I don't even think it was.
Oh, no, wait. No, it's your turn. I just said Porky's, fucker.
Oh, yeah, you did. You did. So Shrek! Is, no, I'm just kidding.
This is your third.
This is my third.
Yes, sir.
All right. Oh, I might go low budget again. Actually, I don't even know. I was thinking Employee of the Month, but I don't really know that that was.
That was a pretty mainstream movie.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. We got Ryan Reynolds and shit. I gotta sit and ponder on that one a little bit, I think.
Hey, take your time, my man.
You've already claimed Clerks.
I actually did not claim Clerks. I took Napoleon Dynamite
and
Porky's.
That's right, you did. You took Napoleon.
You may take Clerks if you want it.
Clerks was good. I honestly, I think I'll have to go with Up in Smoke, though.
Okay, you know, I can live with that.
Up in Smoke, just, I don't know. I feel the reason why I like the movie as much as I do is the first time I watched it was with my dad. And I guess essentially it was just the feeling I got while I was watching that movie with him, and he was like explaining things because I had no fucking idea. Like, I didn't know drug culture. Talking about the cocaine and her teeth is blue and it was dishwasher detergent or some shit. And she's just, oof, oof, oof. It's such a good movie.
That is a good movie.
I believe it was 79 or 78 that was launched. Might have been 77. I can't remember. I just know it was sometime
yeah,
in the
late 70s.
I'm not sure
on that one.
It's a good movie.
But
I would place that probably number two.
It's a good good place for it. List.
Now you gotta...
I think for my third, it's a newer one. But I'm gonna have to go with Tenacious D. And the Pick of Destiny.
Can't argue with that. I believe Comedy Central used to play that one quite frequently too.
I still have that movie. Now I do want to give I have quite a few honorable mentions. Trust me.
Yeah,
I love movies like
this.
Oh, I do, bro. Like Son-in-Law, fucking. You know, like The Cable Guy, Tank Girl. It was based on a comic book, but it was made in like the 90s. It was kind of low budget. It wasn't, you know, the greatest thing in the world, but it was a cool movie.
I'm sorry. Tank Girl, I just think of my cat.
Dude, as ridiculous as a comic book sounds, that's how ridiculous this movie is. And, you know, I mean, like, I've even got Adam Sandler in Airheads. Have you ever seen that?
I feel like I might have seen it once, but I can't remember.
It's the one where he's in a rock band. He's, like, the drummer. It's got Brendan Fraser, and they, like, hold up a recording studio hostage to get heard.
Alright, I'm gonna say I probably haven't seen that one yet then.
Dude, you need to see that. Great fucking movie. You know, and then I've got just, you know, movies like Dazed and Confused. One of my personal favorites is Pulp Fiction. Have you ever seen Pulp Fiction?
Oh yeah.
Gonna say, please, please don't disappoint me on that. Such a good fucking movie, dude. And I wish more people have seen it. I really fucking wish more people have seen it. Just like, have you ever seen fucking Scott Pilgrim versus the World?
Yep.
Dude, I love that movie. It's so fucking cringy.
That was another one that they used to play a lot.
Yeah, they did.
Honestly, I feel like Comedy Central was just the fucking move for cult classic movies.
Dude, I mean, honestly, they were, and I think that's why they actually got a lot of popularity.
Was it Blizzard Lake Studio? Or what the fuck? It was Lizard something. No, I'm thinking fucking, it was Lizard something, but I can't remember what the fuck it was. But then you also have the Lot Lizard bullshit, whatever the fuck that was.
Lot Lizard bullshit.
Yeah, I can't remember exactly what the thesis of the show was about, but something along the lines of truckers fucking. I don't fucking know. I'm tired.
Well, you know, I mean, I get it. It's late. But, you know, we are dads at dark, and we must do these things at the dark.
Oh, fuck, if only Alex was in here to play his soundboard.
I know. He'd be like, God damn!
Fucking Bane reference.
Dude, he perfectly timed that shit earlier.
Fucking did. I don't even remember what I said, but it was timed.
Gotta love it whenever a perfectly timed fucking hotkey hits.
Yeah.
All right, but with that, I think we're gonna call it another I think we're gonna call it a night, everybody. This has been Dads at Dark.